Hi friends, welcome to #TechieMit. So in continuation with the exception handling series related to Java, today I'm going to bring you something that's additional to checked exceptions. And in continuation of that, we'll see about FileNotFound demo, FileNotFound exception demo. So what we need to do when file is not found. So let's go for FileNotFound exception demo. So for that, what we'll do, we'll first read a file, and if the file is not presented, how the program will handle such exception. So we'll see for that. So for that, to keep it simple and understandable, I'll just take one class called as FileReader. I'll take a FileReader object. FileReader. I'll do Control Shift 2. That is omitted. I will mention the path over here. So, for example, I will give some path like this one. This is my hard disk path. Note the path menu. You have to mention. You have to mention in this way. Forward slash times. And let's say I will print some text file that is currently not there, and I'll try to read the file. Then we'll check what kind of exception may occur, how we'll handle that. So let's say I will take ai.txt, which is currently not there. I will give over there, and it's still giving some error, but it unhandle exception type file not found. So you can throws keyword, you can indicate it, or I can handle it using the try catch. Try now I've taken the FileReader object. Now I will try to read from it. So I'll just do a sysout. Note that the path that I mentioned is correct, but there is no file such as ai.txt currently in my this folder, so it should ideally throw an exception. Now let's see how we handle it. Read method. So read method, it is throwing an this thing. It indicates that you should either throw use the throws keyword, note here, or you should catch the exception, that is file not that is IO exception, because the read method, it throws an exception type. You need to handle it. Point to be noted that you need to handle the read exception. So I will take one more catch block over here, and I will indicate as IO exception. Handle this and use Control Shift 2 to import the exception. So when I have exception, I will find out from class file reader, and I will just print the stack trace over here. So see, what you have done, you have taken, here we have taken a file that is currently not existing on our hard disk path, and we are trying to, using the file reader class, your instance, we are trying to read data from the file that doesn't exist. So it should throw an exception ideally, and let's see how it works. Correctly, it's throwing an exception that java.io.findNotFound exception, because this, as I mentioned, ai.txt, that file is not that file is not in our path, not created. So definitely it should throw a file not found exception. So it's been this, as you can see in the stack trace, java.io.filenotfoundException. The path they have mentioned, and they mentioned a system cannot find the file specified. If the system is not able to, point to be noted is that system cannot be, does not find the file in the specified path, it will definitely throw an exception. And these are the structures you can see, and it also shows where it occurs. So it occurs at this time when we were trying on this line 10 by FNF exception demo. When it was trying to read the file that was not non-existing file, it was not able to find out, and it thrown a find not found exception. Now suppose the file exists, then successively it should be able to read the data and print the number of lines read, the read method, because the read method, it returns an integer, so it will return the number of lines read. So for example, I'll take some other another file that is there. So the readme dot readme.md. So I've taken this file as readme.md. That file is there. Note the point over here is that when the file does exist, then successfully you should be using the file reader, you should be able to read the file and print the number of lines, because the number of lines read. So let's see what output it shows on the screen. Exception shall not definitely occur in this case now. Let's run the program once again. Yeah, read data from file 35. So just to correct the formatting once again. So it gives an integer 35. What does 35 indicate? That 35 number of lines are read from the readme file that is using the file reader class. So this is how it works. You may, the alternative to, if you don't want two cache blocks, you may also include one try catch, and using the throws you may throw the IO exception. See, it's not complaining or giving the compiler error, or yeah, so that is gone now. Now let's once again run the program, splitting correctly. The file name I kept the same, but I changed the exception. That is not valid. It should throw an exception ideally. Yeah, correct. Because that file name is correct, but the extension is not correct. So it takes the file name with extension and able to validate extension. And only that it takes into consideration. Otherwise, it surely throws an exception. So this was about file not found exception. So we saw that how we can access a file, and just using a simple class we can read the data from it, and if the file is not present, then user should definitely get an exception. So we saw in this video. So if you don't want the entire stack text to begin, so you can some print also some system sysout message like file not found. So now let's again try to compile the program and run it. See, so now note here, you have catch the exception and you have given here your user defined output for that exception. So when because that such type kind of file is not here, so file not found on specified path, that is the exception. That is the user defined, you give your definition to the catch block, or otherwise you can do the print text as mentioned earlier. So that was about file not found exception and IO exception. So do keep liking, subscribing to #TechieMit. More to come on you on core Java basics and related concepts. And do remember our motto, let's learn Java conceptually. So bye for now.